This year's NBA playoffs begin tomorrow night, and one of the keys to any success the Utah Jazz hope to have centers around the play of a guy they call the mailman.
For Karl Malone, the haircut is part of putting on the game face. You want to look good on the court because, after all, this isn't just NBA basketball. It's showtime.
I consider myself an actor. And when I go out there, I feel like I'm on stage, and I feel like everyone there watching what I do.
Mailman out of play.
And the bigger the game, the bigger the show.
Malone is the consummate power forward. On the fast break, he's one of the most fearsome finishers in the game.
It's like being dominant out there when you're playing because you feel like when you go to the hoop, there's no one going to stop you.
This guy can throw a football 100 yards. I mean, he could probably be a sprinter, a hurdler. He's just a great athlete that happens to play basketball. And like I say, the only athlete I could compare him with is, say, maybe Jimmy Brown.
That's sort of like a goal I have after basketball. It's probably to play football for just for a year, just to see if I could play it. I would like to play defensive end, though. I don't like to get hit. I would like to do the hitting.
Malone also dreams of riding tall on the silver screen. Last summer, he logged his first acting credit in a film set to be released later this year.
Karl Malone is arguably the biggest celebrity in Salt Lake City. He came here 5 years ago as a first-round draft pick out of Louisiana Tech. It's a long ways from his native Louisiana to Utah, in more ways than just mileage.
I was here for 3 weeks, and I didn't see the first black guy. So I'm driving one day, and it's bum. He's on the side of the road, black guy. So I stopped my car, got out, went over and started talking to him. I said, well, where are we at?
Now Malone is very much at home in Salt Lake City. His house includes an impressive weight room for putting the power in the power forward. There's also the unofficial Karl Malone NBA Hall of Fame.
I get all the best players on all the teams. Well, I think the best players.
And when he's not collecting memorabilia, he's collecting pets. There's a cat, a dog, and a massive aquarium filled with fish. There are also plenty of pictures of Mom, who has always been a strong influence, especially on the court.
And she'd tell me about the game last night, what I didn't do. I didn't stand up at the free throw line and follow through. I didn't run wide enough.
But when it comes to his fiancée, Kay, Malone says he's found a perfect bride.
She know very little about the game, just enough.
Malone says he expects to play another 5 years in the NBA, then it's on to the next challenge. Already, he's saving the memories.
Say I have kids, one of these days, they're going to, if they didn't know what their dad did, they're going to, what are you doing? I don't have to say what I did. I can go pull out all my stuff.
Which, at the rate he's going this season, could include an NBA MVP trophy. In Salt Lake City, I'm Michael Kalman, CNN Sports.
All right, you can't count out the defending basketball champs. Of course, the Detroit Pistons leading the way, one of the game's biggest agitators. His name, Dennis Rodman.
Looking for help. He is considered the best defensive player in the league, but he wants it to be official. Dennis Rodman wants the award and is not too modest to say why.
I should. I mean, nobody else is out there that's played tough, aggressive defense like me, but you never know.
The Worm wants it so bad, he's even willing to trade a championship ring for it.
I would rather win the defensive player and give up my ring to my mother. Just give it up. I don't want the ring. I'd rather have the defensive player of the year.
That surprised me if somebody else would say it. But Dennis said it. No, Dennis is a great defensive player. He's the best. He deserves it.
Well, last year I was crying because, I thought I had it. I was like, right around, yeah, I got defensive player. Yeah, that makes me stronger. I can go to play. I play great defense. But all of a sudden, I was really disappointed that I heard I came third.
I think he deserves anything he asked for, except a new barber he should ask for. I think he should ask for a new barber. He's kind of my barber, but his sides are going to some guy who butchers his head while he's asleep.
While his haircut may cause a few snickers, his foul shooting doesn't anymore. In fact, when Chris Dudley went 1-for-18 the other night, the Worm couldn't even relate.
You look at a guy like that, I said, God, I'm great. I'm pretty good at free throw line. But 1-for-18, woo, man, that's pretty bad there.
All right, former Canadian Olympic heavyweight boxing gold medalist Lennox Lewis became boxing's newest millionaire today. He signed a deal with the British TV network, which will net him $2 million for the rights to 10 of his fights over the next 12 months. And that's our show for tonight. Thank you for joining us, everybody. It'll be Mike and Ed Whalen back tomorrow night with Sports at 11 on a Thursday. Have a good night, everybody.
Good night now.
See you then.
Promotional considerations provided by SportCheck, featuring the Sports at 11 sportswear line.